Welcome to Learn to Share. Have you ever been too close to others physically or mentally? Human being is a very complicated species. We all need some space. If someone infringes on that space, you feel unpleasant or even angry with that person. For example, have you ever had argument with your close family member? This happens when they do or say something that gets into your own personal space accidentally. They have no intention to offend you, but when they get into that space, you get mad. This situation can be illustrated with a little animal called hedgehog. Several hedgehogs want to stick together for sharing heat in winter. When they got closer, the spine on them will hurt each other. But when they are too far from each other, they cannot share heat. In this situation, they should find out a certain distance to share warmth and avoid hurting each other. This is called hedgehog's dilemma. How about human? There are two types of distance that we need to bear in mind. As the hedgehogs do, we should figure out the horizontal distance in some relationship. Anthropologist Edward Hall suggested that there are four interpersonal distances of humans. The first one is intimate distance, which ranges from 0 to 18 inches. This distance is only for a very close relationship like couples or your best friends. You may feel loved or have a deep connection with them. The second one is personal distance, which ranges from 1.5 feet to 4 feet. It is for having good interaction among your family or your good friends. You may be relaxed. The third one is social distance, which ranges from 4 to 12 feet. This is for interactions among acquaintances. We know a little bit about them, but we can work with them. The last one is public distance, which is over 12 feet. This is for public speaking. It may cause some pressure on you, and someone may not be able to manage this distance. Apart from horizontal distance, vertical distance indicates the communication between people. We are willing to be understood by others, but at the same time, we are afraid of being hurt by others because of such a close relationship. Why does this dilemma occur? Because we all reserve certain space for ourselves. No matter how close you and the other people are, that space is only for yourself. There are three principles for you to deal with vertical distance between people. To manage a good relationship with the others, you need to respect others' privacy. Sometimes we forget this principle just because we think that we are already very close to each other. For example, Peter and Mary are a couple. One day, Peter was in the toilet and left his phone on the desk. Suddenly, Peter's phone got messages. Mary thought that she can read the message without any permission since they are a couple. Although the message is very general, Peter was a bit displeased by her behavior. Just remember, the closer the relationship, the more respects you need to give. The second principle is offering enough freedom. Some parents may think that they know well about their children because they are very close with their children. They then try to participate in the life of their children. They force their children to study particular subjects to get a great job or interfere in children's social lives. But how do the children think? They may tend to get rid of this close relationship so that they can get more freedom. The better way is let children choose their ways to go and let them know their parents support them. The third principle is giving him or her some space. I need space. It is common to hear from boyfriend or girlfriend. If your boyfriend or girlfriend asks for some space and you may feel frustrated, recall the story of hedgehog's dilemma. Maybe you are too close. What you need to do is just giving him or her some space. Don't dominate over him or her by doing anything. make yourself stronger and better. Try to understand what your partner is seeking for. Once the problems are solved, he or she will be back. In a nutshell, we need physical space and mental space for ourselves. We hate people who break into that space. To maintain a good relationship with others, we also need to learn how to avoid breaking into others' personal space. As long as you are familiar with the distance needed between you and the others, you can develop a good relationship with them.